Hey kids, this is Kalir.
This is Beat.
Let's play Doom RL.
Yay!
All right. We are back in this room. You remember this room, right?
Nope. Wait. Still no. No, nothing.
Okay. Well, this is the Phobos... Well, it was the Phobos Hellgate in earlier versions, but this is the new version, and now it's the Phobos Anomaly.
Phobos Anomaly? What's so anomalous about it?
Well, it's basically the same as before, except with one thing. You know how there was the part where there were the walls that you could destroy that had enemies behind, and when you walked a certain distance in, they collapsed and all enemies rushed you?
I remember that, yes.
You can't destroy those walls in this one until you walk far enough.
So basically they took away the fun part of the game and put it with a boring scripted part.
Well, kinda, because now there is, like... There's still a strategy for it. The strategy is that you rocket jump back to the door that you came from.
I'm kind of amazed they figured out a way to put rocket jumping in a roguelike.
Yeah, it's actually been in there for ages. You just point the rocket in a square near you, and you get blasted depending on how much damage you take.
Makes sense.
We don't have a rocket launcher right now.
Man, those are a lot of little demons.
Lost souls. So we're going to run and get to the door before they murder us all. It might work.
I don't know. It seems like they're doing an awful lot of killing. Oh, then again, one shot took out like four of them.
Yeah, that's what's nice about the shotgun, is it? And also, these guys never leave corpses, so even though we're an Angel of Darkness, that's not a big problem for us.
What happens to an Angel of Darkness?
Just to reiterate, the vision radius is smaller, and enemies will respawn if they have corpses, and you don't remember stuff that's off-screen, but I think some of that is bugged in the graphics version.
I see.
Okay, we're getting kind of injured.
You know about those graphics, dude, making everything all pretty, but at what cost? What terrible cost?
The cost is that he can't see me through that door, so I'm temporarily safe.
Yay, temporary safety!
Alright, where are
you? It's almost as good as permanent safety.
I got a Gatling gun, I'm not afraid to use it.
Make it matter, make it happen.
You are now like a firecracker shot.
You know what? I'm okay with it.
It's a Gatling gun. Can't complain about the noise.
I can, and I will. Alright, we're walking through this door, and there's a sea of blood on either side. That's awesome. I love blood.
Yeah, it's...
Where's that lava?
It's safe to walk through, so it's either, like, blood or just, like, hellstone or something. They have something.
I'm going to assume it is marble.
Now, you remember how enemies will revive?
Right.
And these guys are the Bruiser Brothers. They are the boss of this game. Like, I can kill one with sustained fire from the Gatling gun, but then I have to go back and reload, and I also lose most of my red armor in the process.
Uh-oh.
So, let's see. Can I kill you before I run out of ammo and before that other guy revives? No! No, I can't!
Go and punch him in the stomach. It didn't work for Doom Guy, never mind.
Nope.
This is John Stalmer. He is the penultimate Doom Guy.
Yep. We need a much bigger gun, and we don't have a much bigger gun.
This is looking grim. Things looking grim for poor Johnny boy.
You know what I think we're gonna have to do?
Go berserk? Kill that guy?
Man, I wish we had berserk, but no, I think we're just going to have to run right the hell past them. Because if we just stay here to kill these guys, then not only will they keep coming after us, like, first I try to run away so I can get back to the supply over there and get enough room to get the Gatling gun prepared. But yeah, the Cacodemon, they revive too.
Okay. So, basically you're in big trouble and nothing good is happening to you.
Exactly. This is the Angel of Darkness in a nutshell. Oh, I just killed you. Stay down, fool.
Man, that corpse is so messed up, there's no way that thing's coming back.
I'm not taking any
chances. Only for it to come back.
I'm just going over here.
Going into this hallway. Oh, it's not a hallway, it's a thing.
There's the teleporter.
Oh, you're gone now.
Yeah, you remember this speech? It's like the speech that they gave you at the end of the game normally.
Okay.
The thing about Doom RL, the new versions, is that they actually have three chapters rather than two.
What's the third chapter?
Well, now we're on Deimos, which... We used to go straight to the area of Hell after we beat the Bruiser Brothers, but now, after Phobos, we go through Deimos. Also, we're level 6 now. That's one good thing about Angel of Darkness. You level quick.
Okay, cool.
And then after you go through Deimos, I think you go to the city of Dis, which is basically hell anyway.
City of disrespect.
Yes.
Alright, I'm looking at this screen, and... Oh, wait, there wasn't even a body there. That's just silly.
There was. It was just covered by something.
It wasn't good enough body. We need less body.
Yeah, that's what the Lost Souls are for. They don't leave corpses when killed, because if they did, that'd be kind of ridiculous, because they are fast and easy to kill.
To die without leaving a corpse is the way of the Garo. Man, that game was dark for, like, an E-rated game.
Yeah, it
Nintendo
was.
64.
And that wasn't a reference I was expecting at all.
That's acid all over the place, sort of walking around.
Alright, we got
I know, you were mentioning running past the Dash Brothers, or the Buster Brothers.
Bruiser Brothers.
The Bruce.
Bruisers.
I always really liked the mentality in video games that allowed you to basically just run past difficult fights and the like. I don't know, it presents you with like an alternate way of playing a video game. Like, my sister and I played the hell out of Halo 2, and there's a portion in the second level on Legendary that you just cannot possibly hope to win. Only real choice is just we tried like 50 times, then we said, wait a second, let's just go through it really quick and just not ignore everybody, and that worked the first try. And we were like, oh, new strategy!
Yeah, that's actually... Roguelikes do that a lot.
We are not playing the same Halo anymore. Now we are playing Running Halo. Okay, you're somewhere else now.
We feel the sudden need to run. How about that?
Prepare the Gatling gun. Gatling good.
Oh yes, I do want an agility mod. How kind of you. I have just... Actually, if I can get a plasma rifle right now, I can make a hyper blaster, and I will be so happy with that.
What does hyper blaster do, aside from blast hype?
It uses a bit less ammo than a normal thing. Or boots.
That's good.
And the damage per shot is a bit better. So basically, it's like a more... like, precise kind of plasma rifle. It's very good if you're an entrenchment build, which we... Oh, you destroyed my model. I hate you!
Well, clearly he must die then. This is what happens when people step to you.
Yes. But yeah...
They learned their lesson.
That's the thing in roguelikes, is... If you think that the good way of surviving a challenge is to run, then yes, run. No one's gonna stop you. There are very few cases where you absolutely have to kill something in order to progress.
This reminds me of the other Let's Play you've been doing lately on my EG.
Yeah.
Where you showed us the incredibly insane pacifist run. That was really impressive.
Yeah, it's actually funny thing about that is that in that case, because you get a reward for getting zero kills at all, you spend a lot of time, like... The thing about that is that, yeah, you can play pacifist and you can just run past everything, but why would you do that when you can have so many cool weapons? Like, seriously.
I know, right? It's like the game seemed like it had such awesome weapons. It's like if you were playing Gunstar Heroes and they said, okay, now don't kill anybody.
Yeah, I mean, they have a laser that kicks people in the face.
Yeah. They have, like, a gun at the end that screws up the tiles for no reason. It is a game about awesome weapons. And then it tells you not to use them. That just seems like bad design philosophy.
Well, honestly, I think you should play through it without using the weapons and go for pacifist run once. And if nothing else, if you go through with zero kills, you get one of the most destructive weapons in the game. And you can use it on the final boss.
That's pretty cool.
Anyway, we are...
Struck me as a very, very very ambitious, impressive game. I don't think my computer sucks. I don't think I'd be able to play it, but it looks just astounding.
I think you could probably play it. I mean, I can play it, and my computer can't even run Team Fortress 2 without screwing it up horribly.
Oh, I can't even do that. This is like ancient laptop.
All right.
Okay. So we're walking around. We're avoiding like monsters that just keep coming back. Oh, I like this.
Hell's Armory.
Hell's Armory?
Think we can pull it off?
Yes.
Let's do this. We will go into Hell's Armory where enemies respawn. This is a good idea.
Okay, we're in the armory.
I'm hoping to get as far as I can so I can hopefully get a plasma rifle and then make a hyper blaster. And then we should be set for a good chunk of the game.
Walking right along.
Yeah, I'm not using my Gatling.
Is there a way? This is actually a serious question. I know if you blow an enemy to pieces, it doesn't leave orbs.
Right.
Presumably. Is there a way to destroy an enemy body if you don't have an explosive weapon, or?
If you do enough damage to an enemy with the killing blow, then it doesn't leave a corpse. It's just that certain damage types, like fire from rockets, is better at, like, destroying corpses than others. You can give enemies with any damage type, I think.
Okay. So like, they're still considered as having a corpse. Like, if you just shoot them in the face really, really hard, they have no face left unless the body's there.
Yeah.
That analogy sort of ran away from me.
Okay, we got entrenchment, we have better odds of survival. We might be able to do better with some health. How much health have we got left? I don't know.
Not much. Oh, there's something in there. Kill it.
Be more dead. Now you are more dead.
Is that the same thing?
Yes. He just got up. What a jerk.
Oh, just that quick? I don't know, I assumed, like, when you told me that, the way this game was, that, like, they would give you, like, a little time before I got back up.
Sometimes they do, but...
Like, immediately?
I just
so
noticed...
Is there, like, a timer on it, or does it just pick a random number and say, nope, you're coming back now?
There's a slight timer. Also, we have no med packs. I kinda missed that.
Okay, if I'm looking at this... John Stalburn is dead.
Yes.
John Stalburn is dead. Well, I can't say it was not appropriate. I mean, the end of his story is, and then John was a zombie.
Uh-huh.
And given that everything becomes a zombie in this run, it works. But seriously, man, I thought I had faith in you. Oh, I can't even do this anymore. Goodbye, forever.
I'm sorry. The siren call of Hell's Armory is too much for me. I could have had a hyper blaster on an entrenchment run. Do you know how good that is?
No, you died!
Yes, that's the problem.
Down in heaven, only he's not. He's a zombie. Cursed to walk the Deimos forever.
Yeah.
Oh, all this happens.
Yeah, I could have done better on that.
Defeated the Cyber Demon, killed by Renovance. Defeated the Cyber Demon, killed by John Carmack. Killed by a John Carmack. I love that.
Yeah. Oh, and check the one that says...
Killed by a John Carmack.
Check the one that says, defeated the Mastermind. The Cyber Demon is no longer the final boss in this version, because that's the guy you kill after going through Deimos.
Oh, okay, so who's the Mastermind?
The Spider Matriarch Mastermind thingy.
Oh, okay. So, like... Is it like that girl, like Spider Woman, that I took a photo with at PAX, or is it some sort of...
Super Arachnotron.
Arachnotron, okay, cool. That makes sense.
Anyway, I think we're done for now.
Goodbye, John. We love you.
Later.
Go, Momo.